everyone, and welcome back to Aiden's World of Sports, Episode 2, the live podcast. On the last episode, when we last checked in, we talked about baseball. And in baseball at that time, we were following the ALCS and the NLCS, with the Houston Astros taking on the Boston Red Sox in the ALCS, and the Atlanta Braves taking on the Los Angeles Dodgers in the NLCS. The two series winners of those were the Braves and the Astros, who went on to face off in the World Series. The World Series was epic. It went 6 games, and there was back-and-forth battles for all the games. In Game 1, the Braves' offense went on fire off the rip, where Jorge Soler, a trade deadline acquisition for Atlanta, hit a home run on the first swing of the World Series, something that has never been done before. The Braves' offense didn't stop there in Game 1, and they kept it going throughout the season, throughout the series, where the Braves won in 6. A lot of fans must be happy about this. As we all know, the Astros did have a cheating scandal in 2017, which has diminished their fan base, other than in Houston. Freddie Freeman, notably the Braves' best player, got his first World Series after being in the organization for 12 years. It was a well-deserved ring for him, and fans are happy around the world that the Atlanta Braves, the underdog, won this World Series in 6 games. Jorge Soler was named your MVP, hitting for a .300 average with 3 home runs, 6 RBIs, and a .939 OPS. Crazy, ridiculous stat line, and he deserves that World Series MVP. Jorge Soler and the Braves were on fire as they won the World Series, and they are looking good coming into next year. Freddie Freeman is an impending free agent, but he loves Atlanta, and having just won a ring there, he probably will choose to re-sign. And with that, the baseball season is over. It was a great year, and we'll check back in on the next episode looking at the off-season. And now to take a look at the NBA. Let's check out who's hot and who's not. On the Eastern Conference, we have the Knicks, the Bulls, and surprisingly, the Wizards. The Knicks and the Bulls are the two hottest teams right now at the top of the standings, with the Bulls being undefeated at 4-0 and the Knicks at 3-1 at this moment. They face off tonight. Looking to be a great game, the Knicks and the Bulls will be two teams to watch for the whole season. And surprisingly, the Wizards have been at the top of the standings as well, with Montrezl Harrell, Kyle Kuzma, and Bradley Beal putting this team on their backs. The Wizards are surprising us all, and we'll see if they can sustain it, because everyone thought, including myself, that the Wizards would be a bottom feeder team in the league this year. It's early, but you could tell that something's going on with this Wizards team, and we could see what will happen next time when we check in with the NBA. And for the Western Conference, you have two undefeated teams in the West, the Jazz and the Warriors. The Warriors are looking to bounce back from last year, where a disappointing season saw them getting bounced out of the play-in tournament and not making a playoff spot. They lost to the Lakers and then the Grizzlies, both in crazy close game fashion, just as the Warriors like to do it. They choked, and now they are coming back better than ever. Through 4 games, they have 4 wins, and Steph Curry is leading their team. He's playing like a legitimate MVP candidate, as he hopes to sustain this for the whole season. The Jazz are also 4-0. Donovan Mitchell in his 4th season is taking another jump, and Rudy Gobert is still that defensive anchor in the paint. The Jazz and the Warriors are both playing great, and they're looking to be two teams that can make some noise this year in the West. The Western Conference is loaded, but you know, the Warriors and the Jazz both have really deep teams, and they have studded star power that can lead them to the top of that Western Conference and can potentially get them into a deep playoff run or even win the championship. Who else is hot? Notable starts from Giannis Antetokounmpo and the Bucks, Kevin Durant and the Nets, and on the Western Conference, LeBron and the Lakers have been off to a slow start but are starting to pick it up. The Thunder have been terrible, but hey, Josh Giddey has been a bright spot. He put up 19 points, 8 rebounds, and 7 assists in only his 3rd NBA game. The Pistons have also been terrible, though they have not had presence of their star Cade Cunningham, the number 1 overall pick yet. He looks to return from injury maybe next week, but we will see. Also, the Rockets and Jalen Green have been doing all right, though they can't win that many games. They don't have a great team, but their rookies and their second-year players like Jalen Green, Alfu Sengun, and Jae'Sean Tate are showing out and proving to the NBA that they're going to be a force in the next coming years. Pelicans basketball is looking off to a rough start right now as Zion Williamson is still out and they cannot win games without their star. He's proven to be so much more valuable than we all think he is because he's been overrated and overhated by the media. People are calling him fat as he's gained weight, but it's also that he's gaining muscle. Nobody could guard him in the paint before. Let's see how he is when he comes back from injury, hopefully soon. We love to see Zion Williamson play, and we like to see a competitive Pelicans team because with Zion Williamson on the court, they can make the playoffs and they can potentially make some noise in the first round. And that'll be all for the NBA, and we'll check in next time. Thank you. Top of the morning, top of the morning, top of the morning, top of the morning, top of the morning,
top of the morning. Hold on. And so let's just take a second to welcome our guest, Zach Keller. You want to take a second to talk about yourself?
Yeah, for sure. Thank you for having me on there. I'm Zach Keller. I am the number one player in the state of Colorado. I'm ranked 72nd in the nation. Now I think 10th power forward. I kind of blew up a lot this summer. I played for the Utah Prospects AAU team. They're sponsored by Adidas. I played for them the past 3 years. I played for Thunder Ridge in Colorado. We won state for basketball this past year. And I guess to describe myself as a player, I'm a versatile stretch four. I can dribble, shoot, pass. I can keep the lanes open for drives. I give it all on my defense, and I like to got a good motor, and I'm an aggressive player.
Awesome. So I'm going to take it right into my first question since you kind of did touch on who you are as a player. So my first question for you was, if you have one NBA player, whether it's current or it's all time, to compare yourself to and sort of who you idolize your game after, who do you think that would be and just why?
Okay, yeah. So there's a couple. So one is Jimmy Butler, just for his overall aggressiveness and the heart he plays with on the court, and his defense. He always gives his all on the defense. He's no like Kawhi Leonard, but he always gives his all. You can always see it. And then the other player is Jokic. He can shoot. He can pass. He's good at space on the floor. I'm not as slow as him, but he shows how to take your time. You can still kill people with moves. But those are the two players I kind of watch to idolize stuff off of.
Yeah, and it's really important to idolize something from a center who won MVP. You know, it rarely happens. And now people like, let's say you who are coming up who are taller are now shooting the ball from three more often than it was now with how the game is evolutionized. And so it's amazing to watch these players who are taking their time and now shooting and evolving as centers and bigs. It's really changing the game of basketball.
Oh, yes. The game of basketball is definitely changing because it used to be just center dominated, just throw it in the paint. Now it's shooting from the outside. Basically, everyone has to be able to shoot or else you're not going to be able to play.
Yeah. So my second question for you is, was there one moment as a child, or it didn't have to be as a child, that you really knew that basketball was your thing and that you could make it to college in the NBA and just you really loved the game of basketball more than anything else?
Yeah. So I used to play soccer and basketball. That's where I kind of got my footwork from. That's why I get complimented a couple of times, which I'm very grateful I played soccer. I quit when I was 15. I was 6 foot at the time, got a little too tall, a little five kids running around. He was like, maybe this isn't the sport for me. So that's when I decided to pursue basketball. I didn't think I could maybe go D1 for basketball until like my freshman year of high school. Because that's when I started to, like, finally grow into my body and start getting my athletic ability. Because I used to be, like, the tall, scrawny white kid that just runs down the court, just kind of, like, tripping and falling. And then finally started to grow into it, start to mature. And things started to click. And that's when I kind of realized, oh, maybe I have a future with this. So I started to pursue and go for it a little harder.
Yeah, I mean, it's important. And I see kids playing soccer now in my high school, and you see the footwork. It's all little fast-paced strides that you're moving back and forth, and you're running up and down the field. It really helps you with endurance, and it helps you with little things like playing defense in the paint, because your feet are always moving and you're moving laterally, which is really important. So yeah, that's amazing that you played soccer and basketball and balanced that out. And now you could take some things from one sport and put it into another sport. And now you're amazing at basketball, and you took a lot from soccer to help you with that. That's awesome.
Oh yeah. Every sport gives you something that you can use for another, like being a multi-sport athlete definitely helps a lot.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I can tell just from watching other athletes. You see people like Deion Sanders and Bo Jackson, the main ones. Oh, yeah. And there's people like that all the time now. You see people going in two sports being top picks, like Kyler Murray was football and baseball. And yeah. So I really only have one more question for you, but this one's kind of a big one. So for people who don't know you, you recently just committed to Wake Forest, but you had a lot of offers. And what about Wake Forest stood out to you more than all the other schools, maybe the coaching staff or just in general?
Yeah. So basically with my recruiting process, I like some like big points, good education, basketball program, obviously that's what I play, campus facilities, the coaching staff, do I get along with them, the players, because that's who I'm playing with, gotta make sure I get along with them, and this over like the campus feel. Those are like kind of the main points. Wake Forest, obviously check those out. My final four was Texas Tech, Utah, Wake, and TCU. Those are the kind of ones I felt more of a home to. In the end, it's, you just got to find like the little details. So Wake Forest, a bunch of the players after my visit kept in touch with me for a couple months after my visit. None of the other colleges did that. And the coaching staff kind of felt like a second family. So that's overall why I picked Wake Forest.
Yeah. So from myself, I wish you best of luck at Wake Forest, because I know you're going to be a force in the paint. You're going to be a force in college just in general.
Thank you.
6'7". You could shoot. It's scary to watch your highlights. I've seen some of them. I saw one of your games in the summer, and I looked down at the stat line. It was like 32 points and 20 rebounds. I was like, oh, my God.
Yeah, so, I remember that game.
Yeah. So, you know, I'll be following you. Maybe I'll have you on again after your senior season, like after the basketball season for high school, and we'll see what happens. Best of luck to you. You want to sign off?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, I'd definitely like to come on again after basketball season. Appreciate you. Best of luck with the broadcasting, and hope you can get some better like NBA players. That'd be nice. But yeah, I wish you the best of luck, and thanks for having me on.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Again, we saw a bunch of injuries go down. Never good for the league. But it's even worse for the league when the league's leading rusher is going down for the season. He has a broken bone in his foot, and he had surgery to repair it, but he will likely miss the rest of the regular season. That, of course, is Derrick Henry, a force for the Tennessee Titans offense, and he is the focal point of that team, the best player on that team, and quite possibly the best running back in the league. It's a shame to see him go down with injury, as he was in the midst of an amazing season, on pace to break records, leading the league in rushing with 937 yards, 300 more than the second best rusher. It was amazing to see what he was doing this year, and he was on record pace. Sucks to see him go down with injury. Also, Saints quarterback Jameis Winston went down with a torn ACL against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, and he will also miss the rest of the season. It's a shame for him, as he was having a nice bounce back season after a rough year on the bench and then having to play for the Buccaneers 2 years ago before Tom Brady got there, when he threw for 30 interceptions. Jameis Winston was bouncing back this year, having a great season, and it all comes to an end now as he gets hurt. Their starting quarterback would either be Taysom Hill or Trevor Siemian. As well as these two injuries, Cowboys rookie linebacker Jabril Cox went down with a torn ACL as well, and he will also be out for the rest of the year. It's a shame to see these three players go down with injuries. They were all great and having good seasons. Jabril Cox was leading the Cowboys' defense, which was much improved from last year. Jameis Winston was carrying the Saints on his back along with Alvin Kamara, and Derrick Henry is a force to be reckoned with. So we wish these players a good recovery and to be back better than ever next season. Trade deadline news. Von Miller of the Broncos has been traded to the Rams for a second and a third round pick in the 2022 NFL Draft. And it seems as if the Rams are going all in because they don't have a first round pick, a second round pick, or a third round pick this year. They must want to win now, badly. Their window of time is closing as Matthew Stafford continues to age, and you don't know how long he can sustain his play and ability for. DeSean Jackson of the Rams have been cut, and so is Jalen Smith, the linebacker from the Packers. Nobody would trade for these two, so they got cut instead. And now, on to some sad news. Raiders wide receiver Henry Ruggs has been charged with a DUI resulting in death. It seems that on Monday morning at 3 in the morning, he was driving his car in Las Vegas, drunk, where he crashed into a Toyota, lighting the car on flames after both cars rolled about 500 feet. The passenger and the lady's dog died. It was a 23-year-old female, and the dog died as well when the car went up in flames on impact. Henry Ruggs was treated with non-life-threatening injuries, though they are serious, and he will be charged in prison. He's facing a maximum of 20 years and a minimum of 2. He appeared in court yesterday, and the details were scary. He was driving 156 miles an hour before the crash and was only able to slow to 127 on impact. He had twice the amount of alcohol that was illegal in his blood, and this just was a terrible story to hear. He had so much potential, and he was only a second-year player. We hope he recovers and learns from his mistake. And all prayers go out to the family of the lady and the family's dog. Let's take a moment of silence. She said, take it, you a winner. Let's try it. I just took her home, then I turned into a sinner. She just hit my phone, she said, take it, you a winner. Took her home, then I turn her to a sinner, yeah. I just got a check, I ate lobster for dinner. She like my style, she tryna turn me to an I just woke up, now they say that I'm a star. I just wanna ball, oh my god. Drop off the walk, he just caught a DOI. He think he know the answers, like he built 9. I feel